Hi guys, welcome back to another session at GoTots. I hope you've been having a really fun week. Have any of you started decorating for Christmas yet? If so, which decoration is your favourite? Is it the sparkly tinsel, the star and the angel on top of the tree, or could it be the baubles that you get for hang? Well, I really enjoy having pretty advent calendars to look at, and we've been looking at our Christmas advent calendar. Last week we found Joseph and Jesus. I wonder who we're going to find this week. Well, today's colour is silver. Can you see the silver ones? That's right, they're right here. How many do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a lot of boxes. I wonder who could be behind them. Let's see. Ooh, that looks a bit like an angel. And another angel. We have a shepherd. Another shepherd, and we have a sheep. We have sheep number two. So we have 1, 2 angels, 1, 2 shepherds, and 1, 2 sheep. Any guesses what the story might be about? It was night time and the shepherds were looking after their sheep, who were snoring away. It was very dark and quiet, well, other than the snoring, when suddenly an angel appeared and the shepherds were very frightened. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I bring good news for you and for everyone in the whole world. Tonight, a very special baby has been born. He is God's son and he was born in a stable in Bethlehem and he's lying in a manger." As he said this, a whole host of angels appeared in the sky, singing glory to God in the highest and peace on earth to all men. And then, just as suddenly as they appeared, they disappeared. The shepherds decided that they had to go to Bethlehem to see this baby that the angels had told them about. So they left their sheep behind and off they went to find the baby. And sure enough, in the stable, they found Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus sleeping in the manger, just as the angels had told them. When the shepherds left Jesus, they were singing and dancing and crying out, "Glory to God in the highest." And they told everyone they met along the way about what the angels had said, and everybody was amazed. They had received such good news. Wasn't that such a great story? The shepherds were the first people to hear about this amazing, amazing news. They probably didn't think they were anything special, but God still chose to use them to let the people know about the amazing gift the world had just received. When a baby is born, lots of people come to visit to see the baby and celebrate a new life. Ask your mum and dad who came to visit when you were born. When I was born, I'm pretty sure there weren't any shepherds coming to visit, but how amazing was that that God chose the shepherds to share the good news with first? I know a carol that talks about what the shepherds must have seen when they went to see the baby Jesus. If you know it, you can try and sing along. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. There are so many different ways that we can celebrate Jesus being born, and we do a lot of them on Christmas Day. One of the things that many people do is they give presents to remind us that Jesus was the greatest present of all. People also have a party and celebrate just as the shepherds did when they left the stable. We send cards to our family and friends, just like the shepherds went out and told everyone the good news. And we light candles to remind us that Jesus came as the light of the world to save us. Jesus came to be our friend and to show us how to live a good life. He came to be a light for us and show us how we can be a light for God too. So today I thought that we can make a lantern to help remind us that Jesus came to be a light for us. It's quite simple. All you're going to need is some card, some scissors, either children's scissors or a grown-up to help you with adult ones, and a stapler, which again, I think you're going to need a grown-up to help you with. And it's up to you if you want to decorate this first. If you do, then by all means, you'd want to do that now. So make this as colourful and as arty as you want it to be. And then when you're happy with it, you're going to cut off a strip at the end, a good centimetre to be the handle. And set it to the side. And you're going to fold this card in half. And once it's folded, you are going to cut some strips up the side, but you don't want to cut all the way to the end. You need to leave a gap so that it still stays stuck together. So as you can see, I've cut all the way along, but I've left a little edge at the end. So keep doing this all along your card. Awesome, and when you are done, put it out flat, and then you're gonna fold it around and staple the ends together. If you don't have a stapler, that's fine, you can always use some tape instead. Make sure your fingers are out of the way. A lovely lantern to light up our Christmas. So you can make a few of these and string them up and have them hanging across your room, or you can just put this on your shelf. Wherever you put it somewhere that you can see it to remind you that Jesus came to be the light for the world. As always, if you do our craft, we would love to see it, so you can send a picture or a video to the email address listed below. And we hope that you are doing well. We hope that you are healthy and happy, and we can't wait to see you again. Until next time, bye!